So this is my bike. So this is my transition patrol. It's had a lot of use over the past like year and a bit. It's pretty thrashed, but she's still going. I run it 170 fork. This is where it gets complicated because it's usually 160 front, 160 rear. But I was really between sizes, so I found that it was too big for me. It was too like stretched out. What I did, I like worked out online how to like make it smaller. And the weird thing is, if you put an angle set in it, because I like to be right over the front of the bike, and I like my stem to like be right over the axle. So I put an angle set in, which steepens the head angle, and it also lifts the frame up, which brings it higher, which reduces the frame reach. So it kind of bridged the gap between sizes for me. And it also, at the same time, had that effect of steepening the head angle, which meant I can get more weight for the front. But because it also, as it comes forward, it also raises the front end. It keeps it slack-ish. So it's about 63.5 degree head angle right now. Whereas if I had it 170 without the angle set, it would be about 63. Oh no, it'd be 62.5, which is so slack, it's insane. So yeah, that's the front end. If you want to get one, something to run it like that, you go on workscomponents.com, find your headset, and I've gone for a 1 degree angle set, which is all you need to bring it back. So yeah, onto the rear, I've got Cascade Components Cascade Link. These are so good. So I'm running a shorter stroke shock, which is, well, it would be 160 without the Cascade Link, but you can run a longer stroke shock on these. And I thought it was a bit of a gimmick when I first got it, but it was insane. I took my old link off, put that on, rode it, put the other link back on, rode that, and I instantly went back to this because it's just so much better. It just feels so much better. It just ramps up more and like, it's just, I'm actually running a harder spring. So you can run like a harder spring, but it's still so supple for the top, so you get way more grip. It's just way better. I'm running DT Swiss EX511 and FR560. That should probably be at the back, but it's just what I had. Pope Pro 4 hubs, front and rear. Pro 4 is good, really serviceable. I like Hope parts because they're all just really serviceable. Continental CryptoTel super soft. Rear Continental CryptoTel super soft front. I love these tires. They're like cheat codes. They're so good. I got one up dropper. That's just out of service, even though it doesn't look like it. The shock is RockShox Super Deluxe Ultimate Coil, the one with the HBO. And personally, I think that is probably one of the best shocks on the market at the moment. It's so good. Just straight out of the box, you can just whack on your bike and it's just so good. I'd have one on every single one of my bikes, and I'd have one on my demo as well, but it doesn't fit on my demo. It's really annoying. So yeah, remember that if you buy a specialized demo, don't put one of these on because they don't fit. They hit the frame. RockShox Zebs, these forks are insane. I love them. Renfrew handlebars, always run Renfrews. I love the sweep and the just the feel of them because they're not too far back. I hate too much back sweep. Brakes are Hope Tech 4 E4, so the enduro ones with the SRAM HS2 rotors. Those rotors are sick, they're slightly thicker and like just gives you a really nice lever feel, and they manage temperatures really well. Could have gone for the V4s, but I didn't really feel the need on my enduro bike. And then for the cranks, they are Uniteco 160mm. They're 160mm length. I've just started using them, so I can't really give an opinion on the short cranks. I don't really know how it feels yet, but I was running 165 before and they feel quite similar, if not a little bit nicer. I found it a little bit harder to manual them, but it's probably just gonna get used to it. HD Talon pedals, I got given these off my friend who borrowed my bike when he lost his bike, when he forgot his pedals at Dovey, and he just borrowed my bike. So yeah, he gave me these for free, what a legend. Yeah, that's about it really. That's my enduro bike. That's the special bits. I run it tubeless. And I got a little tool in there, which is really useful because I'm a faffer and I always faff around with stuff. That's one. One of my bikes.